morning and good evening to all. So whoever joining over the India, so good morning whoever the joined outside Indian countries. Okay, good evening to all. And so see, in before 2017, so Microsoft is purely on Windows base. So on SQL is completely on Windows base. On 2017, SQL 2017 onwards, Microsoft introduced one more platform called Linux platform. So where you can go and install SQL on completely on Linux. Okay, so but entirely different. It is entirely different. Okay, but everyone, as I'm telling, everyone need to learn about the Linux environment, basic commands. So we have different flavors in Linux, not like Windows. Windows, we have Windows operating system 2008, 2012, 2016. So like same. So when you go for Linux, so we have different flavors: Red Hat, Ubuntu, CentOS. Mostly these are the three flavors mostly we will use in real world when you go for Linux base. Okay, Red Hat and CentOS will use one set of commands. Okay, so but Ubuntu will use some different set of commands. Only that is the one difference. Apart from everything is same. So everyone need to learn the SQL on Linux. Means you need to learn about the first Linux operating system. So what are the basic commands to know everyone to work on the Linux environment, along with, so from 2019 even Microsoft introduced one interesting concept called Docker. Okay, where you can install your SQL over the Docker containers.
Okay, so what is the Docker stand for?
Docker is a container level, like you have the virtual machines, right? VMwares, where you can here you can call it as a VMs. Okay, Hyperview or Oracle Virtual Box, right? Same way you can create containers. You can create a containers with the help of Docker. So for Docker, it's a very easy. It is not a very complicated. Okay, but if you wanted to work with the Docker, you need to know about the Docker file. So we need to write a small piece of code in the Docker file. That Docker file contains actual data. It's a container base.
Okay, so yeah, okay, so that's something interesting. I haven't heard about it. So I mean, so I heard like a SQL DB job will not be available in next 5 years, right? Because everything's moving toward cloud. So why they need DBAs? Because everything going to be automation. So that is the concerning part, you know. So that's the reason I'm trying to switch over to another field as well. So even though I have a 4 year of experience and, you know, getting good money, like working in US, but it's still kind of concerning part. So everybody's switching off to the cloud stuff. So it was like, you know, so everything is automated. So they don't need like DBA nowadays.
That is a question everyone is rising to me even. So multiple people ask the same question. So what is the future? So no need to worry, it is a Microsoft product. It is a complete Microsoft product. See, when you go for data science, so in data science, we have the, like where we are going to use the reporting tools, right? So what are the reporting tools they will use? Tableau, Power BI, correct? So when you go for Tableau, when you go for Power BI, so Tableau can use any database. Power BI will use the default Microsoft. So even when you go for data science also, you need SQL because they need to store the data. So even you make automation also, a DBA people must and should need. You cannot see, we are using one automation tool like a Puppet to install the SQL. So we never install the SQL normally. What I will show you to you, or who are you are installing the SQL also. But even we use the automation Puppet, we need to perform manual task. So changing the service request, service account request, changing the default configuration parameter, post installation parameters, that we need to do manually. Even you make the automation can do only 50%. Rest 50% DBA must and should perform. So automation cannot resolve the performance tuning, right? Automation cannot resolve the like any latency issues or any services down. automation cannot. So DBA people can. So no need to worry. So you will be safe for next 10 years because you are learning the Microsoft. So you are the part of Microsoft. Okay, because Microsoft make a good R&D, research engineering and department. So he is the one best R&D team he will maintain. And he is the best competitor for all database management system. He is the top leading database management system. In one survey, I can show you as a survey as well in 2019. And he is the best competitor for Oracle as well, because earlier versions where SQL is completely on Windows, everyone is getting afraid maybe virus will be affected for Windows, right? But Microsoft implemented SQL completely SQL on Linux base. Now it is no need to worry about the virus. It's the antivirus, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So that is the
So you will be including like Linux in your class, or is going to be everything we need to learn in the side?
No. I will take a two sessions completely. So how to perform installing over the Linux? What are the basic commands of the Linux? How to install the? I will tell two flavors. One is I will go for Ubuntu. One is I will go for Red Hat. So both I will show you how to install the SQL services. What are the default commands? Okay, what is the difference between Ubuntu and Red Hat in the command level? So I will show you.
So also quick question, right? So because looks like in this group, like we have like a lot of people from the beginner to the intermediate, right, to the expert. So how your class going to be categorized? So do you going to have like separate session for like, you know, based on the skill set, or you're going to be adding everybody into the one class?
So that is what, once we finalize two demos, then I will ping separately and I'll ask them who are interested over this session. So out of this, again, if you are working, again, I'll ask you. So we have three different modules. So module one, I'm going to cover complete SQL DBA core part. Module two, I'm going to cover complete Azure. And module three is entirely different. Module two is completely for who are working as a, who are already working as a DBA, but they are very basic knowledge on the tuning. So module three is only for the tuning level. So completely we'll go for live demos.
So what about only private session? Sorry? Like, is there any way you're gonna have like private session, like one-on-one session like that?
Yeah, I can go for one-on-one session over the weekends. So you can ping me. So whoever wants a module three, okay, you can ping me separately, so I can make a separate session for you.
Okay, great.
But
thank you.
Only for weekends. Yeah,
got it.
So that is what I will request you people. So whoever want module three, so whatever you have the doubts, just make a notes and share it to me. So whatever I know, I am sharing to you knowledge, right? No, I don't want like this. Whatever you have the doubts, you first share it to me. I will explain you same thing to you. And along with my course, additional. So for example, I am providing CPU, memory, IO, indexes, SQL OS, schedulers, threads, everything, right? Apart from, you feel something I'm missing, you can suggest me. Okay, that also I can cover over that part of the course. Okay, because few people also working, right? So my environment is different, your environment is different, I am facing different kind of issues, you are facing different kind of issues, I am not sure whatever the issues you are facing, right? So that issues you can ping me, I can explain you, it will help you a lot in future. Okay, anything? Okay, so coming to about me. Okay, so myself is Subbu. You can call me as Subbu. So I have total 7 years of experience as a SQL Server data platform. Major skill set area is high availability and disaster recovery solution designing and implementation. Okay, and advanced backups and recovery level, and participated in EOL activities. So mostly I will participate on EOL activities like end of life activities, like where I'm going to perform upgradations and migrations, like both in-place upgradation and migration, side-by-side migration, and mostly I will involve on the performance tuning level. Okay, So advanced performance tuning and optimization. Also along with, so I have one interesting concept like MSBA. So I also involved in troubleshooting and troubleshooting and configuration on MSBA, like Power BI, SSRS, SSIS, SSIS. So we are going to cover all this concept as well along with this course. Okay, how to install the SSIS, how to configure, how to install SSRS, how to configure. And currently I'm working as a technology analyst in one of the best MNC company in Bangalore. Now, this week I have switched to another company. So as a technology specialist. Okay. So, and my client is Microsoft. And currently I'm interested to learning and working in Azure, SQL and the other cloud providers of the Microsoft. Means other cloud products and like services. So we have the around 200 to 300 services provided by Microsoft. So I am going to learn some more services which will help you and which will gain my career. Okay. So feel free to contact this number. So if you have any queries and if you stuck somewhere, okay, you can WhatsApp me, you can call me anytime. So I'm going to cover all these sessions. Okay. So first is advanced performance tuning and optimization. Then I will cover. Then we are going to cover complete SQL Server DBA core part. In Azure, we are going to cover IaaS and PaaS, Platform as a Service, Infrastructure as a Service, and we are going to cover as a SQL as well. And completely end-to-end real-time scenarios. Okay, so every don't get confused. I won't tell in last sessions. Okay, so each concept I will explain you complete real time. So end-to-end real time. So what are the important questions, where you need to focus? So that is also I will tell you in the same day itself. So clear? Any queries? Online people, everyone clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, so complete today agenda is, so I will brief about the history of the SQL Server and what is our roles and responsibilities. Today and tomorrow we are going to cover this agenda. Okay, first two demos we are going to cover. So what is the history of the SQL Server and what is the jobs role, what is our job roles and the responsibilities. So what are the responsibilities for each role? Okay, we have the different roles in Microsoft. Okay, that all roles I will going to cover and what are the responsibilities for each role and how to become the SQL Server DBA. So that is also we are going to complete. So we are going to cover this part of the course. And who is the SQL Server DBA expert? Make right decision. So how you are making a decision if something goes wrong? So that decision is nothing but expert. So that I am going to show you in a just presentation level. So throughout the course, once you complete the course, you will become a SQL Server DBA expert. Okay, because we are going from scratch to internals to high level. So from basic to high level. So every session. Okay, the first, let me go to the sum what we are going to cover here. Okay. So about the SQL Server DBA course, so we will provide you with all the skills required to become a successful database administrator. So I'm going to provide you all the content. So how do you become a database administrator? Our course will teach you from the basic from Microsoft SQL Server 2019. So we are directly starting with the latest version, okay, 2019 itself, and we are making the practice. We are playing with the instance from the SQL 2019 itself. Okay, we are not going for SQL older versions. We are playing with current version, which is SQL 2019 is the Microsoft current latest version. So mostly still not at using most of the projects. So most of the projects still not at use 2019. They are using 2014, 2016, 2012 versions, but we are playing with directly with the 2019 instance. Okay, so completely like architecture level, query designing, SQL clustering, performance tuning, and more throughout the work with the real-time project. So I'm going to explain you how the DBA project will look like. So what are the activities you will perform? What is your role, current role? What kind of different projects you will get it? So what are the activities you will perform mostly, that I am going to cover. We are going to prepare the resumes for everyone. Okay, so I will place in the portals, Naukri and Monster. These are the two portals, job portals, mostly widely we will use in India. Along with, we'll take some mock interviews. So that mock interviews based on your interest. So you can feel free to contact me. So sir, can you please take the interview for me? So I will take you interviews. Along with, I will provide you one material and the interview questions as well. So what are the most frequently interview questions you will get it? So that I will provide you in separate article. So clear? So all sessions are recorded. Every second, every recording will be backed up. Okay. So if you miss any session due to some personal issue or due to some network issue, because as we are facing, everyone is facing due to COVID. So everyone is supporting from home, and we are facing some network issue, right? Bandwidth issue. So no need to worry. Every session is recorded and every session is backed up. You can feel free to download anytime. And you can go and you can refer that video. And after that, if you have any doubts, you can ping me personally. So clear? Any queries? Online people?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Again, So I told you, right, we are divided into three modules. One is DBA core, one is the tuning, one is completely we are going for Azure. Okay, in core DBA, we are going to cover high availability and disaster recovery solutions, completely end-to-end practical. Okay, from the scratch onwards, we are going to practical always on and clustering. Most of the people don't know how to build the cluster and how to build the always on. So because to build a cluster and to build always on, you require minimum 8 GB RAM. Okay, so you require minimum 8 GB RAM if you wanted to build, if you wanted to configure from the scratch level clustering always on. Only these two techniques, if you wanted to practice, you require minimum 8 GB RAM. Okay, so rest everything you can do with the normal your configuration. 4 GB RAM is sufficient for the SQL. Okay, you can install how many instances you want and you can do the practical. You can play with the SQL instance. With 4 GB RAM is enough, sufficient, and iCore processes also, i3 process is sufficient. Okay, but if you wanted to play, if you wanted to do the practice from the scratch for the clustering and always on, you require minimum 8 GB. So I will explain you complete, from the scratch level, clustering and always on. So completely for cluster, to build the cluster, I will take 8 hours. Okay, so 8 hours, 4 hours one day, 4 hours one day. So over the weekend I will plan and I will show you from the scratch level. So how to build the VMs, how to configure IP address, how to configure the SanDisk, everything I will show you from the scratch itself. So all installation, configuration, security part will go from the scratch. When you go for the tuning, so memory, IO, CPU, SQL OS. Okay, so indexes, along with indexes also, we are going to complete, we are going to do from the live sessions. So we will while we are running any demos, so it will automatically, your memory will grow to 100%. So after your memory is utilized 100%, how you will tune, so how you will identify which query is consuming more memory, consuming more CPU. Okay, so which is eating IO, inputs, outputs. So that we are going to see with the live demos along with the SQL OS architecture. So completely we'll go from the schedulers level, threads level, preemptive scheduler, corporate schedulers. So what is the quantum CPU? Okay, everything will go from the scratch on the tuning part. This is the somewhat different. Tuning is something is like a L3 level. So we have three kind of DBAs: L1 DBS, L2 DBS, L3 DBS. So for your understanding, junior DBA, senior DBS. Okay. So what are the activities done by junior DBS who is having less than 4 years? Okay. So 1 to 4 years they will part of L1 DBS. Mostly they will do L1 activities. Where if having more than 4 years to 7 years, so they are belong to L2 DBS. So mostly they will work all critical activities. Then top of the layer we have L3 DBS. So who is having more than 8 years experience? So they are completely on the end-to-end troubleshooting part. So troubleshooting and UL activities they will perform. Okay, so we are discussing complete L3 level. So tuning will go for L3 DBS. So basic core part will go for L1, L2 DBS, and tuning is the advanced for L3 DBS as well. Along with we'll go for Azure. In Azure, we are going to learn complete IAS, so and PaaS and SQL, Azure SQL as well. So clear? Everyone clear?
Yes. Yeah, but there is something called L5, right? So L5 stand for what? L5. So because I have a team, right, and some DB are considered as a L5, and they have like 8 year of experience.
Maybe L5. See, not sure. See, each role will have the unique responsibilities. Okay, each level having some unique responsibilities. So based on the organization, based on the projects, it may differs. Okay. See, L5 in the sense maybe database architect level, where they are going to directly interact with the clients to get the requirement. To get the requirement, they will gather the information. So mostly they will interact with the engineering and department team. So they will interact with the application. They will directly contact the application teams to get the projects. See, projects in the sense applications, to get the applications. So that kind of levels. But L1, L2, L3 is a basic, mostly they will involve over the SQL activities. So where we have different roles like subject matter expert, SMEs. So subject matter expert. So he is also a person who is directly interacting with the clients. A new requirement, new enhancement, or any enhancement, any requirement, he will get it from the clients and he will educate the L1, L2, L3 DBS. So this is the requirement newly introduced. So we need to be careful. All this will get from SMEs, project managers, delivery managers. So that differs from each organization. So when you are working in India, when you are working in different countries, will change. Okay, please be mute who are not speaking, okay? Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so a basic introduction. So about what we are doing actually. Everyone will get confused. What is SQL DBA? What is Microsoft SQL? What we are doing internally? What is IT first of all? What IT people is doing? See, very simple. Let me tell you. So you are opening the sites where everyone knows Facebook. Take Facebook, take Flipkart, take Amazon. Everyone knows, right? Take any bank like Citibank, HSBC Bank, okay, ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank. Everyone, when you are opening the portal, that portal when you are opening from the browser, internet browser. So what is happening? It is a front end, and whatever you are seeing over the screen, so we will call this a front end. Every front end is designed by Java, .NET, PHP, HTML, CSS, okay, WordPress. So every front end, whatever you are seeing, that we all call it as a front end. So every front end is designed by these technologies, okay. But so when you open the Facebook, when you open any e-commerce application like Flipkart or Amazon, you need to log in, right? So you will first sign in. So where your data is storing? Where your data is storing? So in the data center. your data is storing in the data center, your data centers look like this. So this is the backend picture is data center. Contains gigabytes of data, contains rack of servers. So technically you can call it as a, each box technically you can call it as a rack. Each rack will maintain common storage, common network. Okay, each rack will contain the multiple servers. Each server will maintain common network, common storage. Okay, all the racks will have the common network and common storage. So what exactly happening, right? So assume this is your application, and this is, this side is a complete database level. Whenever you send a request, so it will directly interact with your database. When you are clicking on the submit button, what is happening? Internally through network, it is able to communicate with the database servers. And it is checking whether you are, whatever your login you are providing, whatever the password you are providing. So it is incorrect or so correct or incorrect. Sometimes you will, by mistake, you will provide the wrong password, by mistake, you will provide wrong username, right? It will directly, you will get the pop-up call, invalid username, invalid password, right? So getting my point, online people?
Yes.
So this is what happening internally. Multiple requests. Just take one best example. Go to the Google. How many servers Google is maintaining? Not sure. No one knows. How many servers YouTube is maintaining? How many servers your Netflix is maintaining? Whatever you are searching over the net, sorry, YouTube, whatever you are searching over the Google, you are getting the information, right? How it is getting the information? So backend, every server is interacted with the database server. All your data will be residing in the DB servers. Not only our SQL, okay, we have n number of database management tools like go for Oracle, MySQL, PostgreSQL, Teradata, DB2, Sybase, okay, MongoDB. Recently we have the MongoDB as well, non-relational database management system. Okay, so let me tell you who are the first time you are seeing about this one. Just hold. Okay, this is the high level presentation for 2 days. Okay, what you are going to learn, no worry, after third day you are going from the scratch itself. Okay, so whoever starting your career on the IT, just hold. Okay, don't get afraid. Okay, so you will get from the scratch. Okay, this is the high level presentation. What
found on the web.
Okay, what exactly happened over the IT. So every, whatever you are doing over the front end, there will be back end where you are storing your data. So this is how your request is happening. So this is your laptop. Assume, take, this is your laptop. When you are clicking submit button, when you are opening your bank, when you are connecting Facebook, what is happening? It is sending request to the server, which is residing over the data center. So that data center having multiple servers. Got it? Clear, everyone? How the data center will look like, okay, how you are sending the request, what is happening over the back end, how they are connecting throughout the world is connected with the network. Okay, then you will get wondered, sir, mostly we are supporting on-site projects, right? US project, UK project, Australia project, Netherlands projects. How the global is connecting? Every globe is, see, entire the globe is connecting with the network. Every, throughout the globe is connecting with the network only. So when you go to the oceans, you can see the tunnels. You can see the tunnels. No need to worry about all this concept. Okay, I will show you practically how to create the tunnels. Okay, in when you go for Azure. Okay, when you go for Azure, I will show you how to create the tunnels. Like normally, how the traditionally we are creating the tunnels, right? In oceans, like same, we will create the tunnels in Azure. Okay, so I will show you practically, no need to worry. So throughout the globe is connecting with the networks. And even when you go to the ocean also, you can see the large tunnels with the large, huge wires. In technical, non-technically, we can call it as a, okay? So that is how you are able to access every server globally. You can, so how you are supporting work from home? See, my client is in US. I am supporting from India. How I am able to connect to the US? Through network. Throughout the globe is connected with network. Without network, ended down completely. Got it? So clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, a basic, a simple basic history about the SQL. Okay. So Microsoft SQL Server is among the biggest and most broadly utilized database management framework. Okay. Throughout the global, everyone using Microsoft SQL Server. See, one of the two most of the companies will use mostly SQL when compared to other database management system. Mostly US, UK people. Mostly when you go for UK, most of them, 70 to 80% will use SQL Server. Even when you go for South Africa as well, so mostly they will use SQL Server when compared to Oracle. Okay, so it is a broadly used database management system throughout the world. Okay, so Microsoft is implemented with Sybase. Okay, based on the Sybase, Microsoft SQL Server is designed and implemented. So, and Microsoft is implemented the first version in 1989. So 1989, Microsoft implemented first version. That version is 1.0. That version is 1.0. And he break the relationship between now. Entirely, he owned the partnership. So however, the partnership between the two ended in the year is 1990. Okay, 1990. So Sybase and Microsoft become the two different database management system. Okay, before 1990, so Microsoft and Sybase is the one, two combinedly both are working on 1990. So Microsoft break the partnership and he's implemented his own Microsoft SQL Server. Microsoft started his own partnership from the SQL 1990 onwards. And we have various versions. So Microsoft introduced various versions. But as of now, we are going to mainly focus on all this version. But no need to worry about 2000, 2005, 2008, 2008 R2. Okay, because Microsoft already stopped the support. So he already announced that we are going to stop the support for 2000, 2005, 2008, 2008 R2 version as well. So now latestly, we are going to use 2012, 2014. 2016, 2017, and 2019 version. Clear, everyone, online people? Any queries? Any queries, online people?
No.
Okay. Yeah. See, when you go for SQL, so we have, when you go for developer, okay? So we have concept called SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. Okay, Structured Query Language. So we have a separate session. So I will take a separate session. So what basically developers will do? So what activities they will do? So what is the what are the languages available in SQL? So what is the TSQL? What is the difference between SQL and TSQL? See, without knowing the basic knowledge, you cannot directly jump into the DBA. Okay, I will take a separate session for the development skills as well, where I can show you. So what are the languages available? What exactly they will perform? Which developer will perform? Okay, so then we'll go for the complete end-to-end DBA part. Okay. So when you go for database, so we have the structured query language for where we are going to use for Oracle. When you go for Oracle, when you go for MySQL, when you go for Sybase, when you go for DB2, you can call it as a SQL only. But when you go for TSQL, okay, when you go for programming level, so we have different names. So in SQL, Microsoft SQL Server, where you are calling it as a TSQL. Okay, transaction SQL. But when you go for Oracle, where you can call it as a PLSQL. Okay, PLSQL, where you can call it as a programming language SQL. okay, where they are going to implement. See, whatever the futures we are going to use on T-SQL and PL/SQL, both are same only, but the name is different. Okay, but name is entirely different. So we will write a stored processor, we will write a functions, we'll write a cursors, we'll define the cursors, we'll define the triggers in T-SQL and PL/SQL. Okay, that will take a separate session where everyone need to know the basic about development skill as well. Okay, not in detail. Okay, it is not a development course. Okay, as a DBA course, first, before directly jump into DBA, everyone need to know about the basic about the developer, what exactly developers are performing, then we can go into the DBA concepts. Sorry, so are you're not able to hear my voice, online people?
Yeah, we are able to hear.
We are able to hear.
Okay. So try to, my request is try to everyone connect via phone and keep the headset, okay? So better, you will get better internet. So as everyone is facing some network bandwidth issues, okay? So instead of connecting laptops or desktops, okay? So try to connect all your smartphones and keep just headset, okay? It's very good. So maybe bandwidth will be good. Now, so let me go to the most popular database management system available. So these are the most database management system throughout the global. Okay, Oracle, IBM DB2, okay, SAP HANA, Microsoft, Teradata, MySQL, PostgreSQL, Amazon Aurora, okay, MongoDB, Hadoop. These are all the database management system. So these are all the database management system. Each database management system having unique features, unique responsibilities. Okay, so when you go for Oracle, when you go for DB2, when you go for SAP, when you go for Teradata, when you go for Hadoop, okay, see, as everyone knows about the Oracle, right? Everyone knows about the Oracle is a leading database management system throughout the global when compared to Microsoft as well. Okay, so IBM is having its own database, that is a DB2 database. So DB2 is the IBM database. Okay, mostly they will use for mainframes. So when you go for ATM machine, right, all your ATM machines is working with the mainframes and AS400. All your mainframes database is DB2. Okay, so but mainframes is completely working with a black screen. When you open the command prompt, right, it is a black screen, right? Your mainframes is also completely end-to-end black screen. But how you are getting the color screen when you go for ATM machine? So your mainframes is integrated with Java. Your mainframes is integrated with .NET. So for better color, okay? So but your mainframes is completely working with the DB2 databases. As everyone knows, so SAP is having own database, that is SAP HANA. SAP HANA is a database. Okay, so it's having its own database. But SAP people also interact with the Microsoft. So I will show you how to integrate Microsoft with SAP, how to integrate Microsoft with Oracle. Okay, so in coming sessions, no need to worry. MySQL. So now MySQL is purchased by Oracle. So Oracle purchased completely MySQL. Before one or two years back, Microsoft is a open source. Anyone can use the MySQL now, but it is a licensed version. Okay, so because Oracle purchased the complete MySQL and he making some licensed versions. So if you want to go and use the top features in MySQL, then you need to purchase the license from the Oracle. Okay, so everyone knows, right, big data. So for big data, backbone is the Hadoop. Hadoop is the database management, and MongoDB is a completely different. So recently it is implemented and it is a non-relational database management system. Okay, MongoDB is completely different when compared to all this. So all are relational database management system. Okay. So what is the difference between non-relational, relational? I will explain you in coming slides. Okay. So MongoDB is a completely non-relational database management system. Even my AWS, when you go for AWS also, we have Amazon Aurora is own database of my Amazon. So these are the top database management systems which we are using globally. Okay, so then why I need to prefer Microsoft out of this all database management system? I can go for SAP, I can go for Hadoop, I can go for Oracle. Then why I need to prefer Microsoft? Okay, so this is the survey. Every year we will have the survey. Okay, out of this survey, which is the topmost leading database management system? Everyone? So which is the topmost management system, database management system throughout global?
Oracle.
No. Can you please see?
Microsoft.
Yes. Microsoft. So Microsoft is the topmost database management system in global, because so Microsoft went a different platform called Linux. Okay, on 2017 Microsoft introduced completely different platform, Linux platform. Then Microsoft went to top level. Okay, so when compared to license cost also, Microsoft is less license cost when compared to Oracle. Okay, so and even Microsoft directly announced, if someone is migrating complete their project from Oracle to Microsoft, so Microsoft will take a responsibility to migrate the data, and 1 year license free. Okay, 1 year license, completely license free. Microsoft directly announced that whoever is switching their project from a different database management to Microsoft, so you no need to worry. So Microsoft people will help us completely for migrating your data from Oracle to SQL, SAP to SQL, HANA to SQL. So completely, and 1 year license completely free. Okay. So this
Oracle
is the survey
done by SQL.
So sorry.
The Oracle database are compatible to the SQL.
Yes. So we are creating the linker servers, right? So we will create the linker servers and we'll make integration between Oracle and Microsoft SQL. We will create a linker servers between SAP and Microsoft. So it is a compatible.
Okay.
But they need to redesign the code. So that is what I told you, right? Previous slide. So when you go, for this slide, okay. So in SQL, we are writing the T-SQL statements. Okay. When you go for Oracle, we are writing PLSQL statements, but some declaration is different. Okay, apart from the concept is same. Okay, concept is everything is same when compared to all the database management system. Only the difference you will notice is declaration part. How you are going to declare the variables, that will be differs. Got it?
Yes.
Everyone got it?
Got it.
So why you are choosing the Microsoft? Okay. And let me brief about what are the components available in SQL. Okay, so these are the components which is available in SQL, where we have the T-SQL programming language. Okay, so on the query tuning, so this is the whoever the writing the T-SQL, they also belong to the tuning. So how they are developing the code, so the code need to be developed properly, otherwise what will happen, it will impact the application performance, right? So developers also make sure that how they are designing the code, how they are writing the stored procedures, how they are writing the queries, so that is also will help tune the queries as well. And the major components, and when you go for the major components level, okay, here is the major components. One is SQL database. When you go for SQL database, you can go for basic DBA along with the advanced level, from basic to advanced level. Okay, and we have one more major component is MSBI, Microsoft Business Intelligence. Microsoft Business Intelligent. Okay, in Microsoft Business Intelligent, we have the three different tools. Now we have four different tools actually. Please be mute all, okay? Please be mute all. Okay, so now we have four different tools which we are going to use in MSBA. That is SSIS, okay, integration service, analysis service, reporting service. When you go for reporting service, we have two different tools. One is SSRS, one is Power BI. So Power BI is introduced from SQL 2016 onwards, okay, advanced for SSRS. Okay, so when compared to SSRS, Power BI is the advanced level tool with more bar charts, pie charts, okay, with more graphics, and from SQL Server 2017 onwards, where you can directly run the Python over the SQL, even because Microsoft is completely integrated our SQL Server into machine level language. That is nothing but data science. Okay, so now everyone is using, okay, data science is the leading technology throughout the global. Microsoft completely integrated your SQL into machine level language. You no need to worry about the Python. You can directly run your Python code in SQL. You can directly run your R language in SQL. These are the two languages, topmost languages in the data science, Python and R. You can learn any one of the languages. Either you can go for Python or you can go for the R language. So both are the two topmost languages using in the data science. That is integrated in SQL Server. Means you can directly run Python in SQL, you can directly run R language in SQL, and you can make automation. You can make automation with help of Python, you can make automation with help of R language of the SQL. Got it? Everyone got it, online people?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, yes.
Sorry, can you, sorry, so what is the R language? Can you provide more detail on R language?
Not sure, okay. So it's like a, it is also one competitor like a Python. So when, see, Java is a language. So mostly everyone knows Java, right? Okay, so whoever writing. So Java, for Java, better than Java, we have the Python. Okay, because Python having more automation. Okay, so if you wanted to connect to the SQL, no need to write 100 lines of code. Okay, so for example, if you wanted to write automation, if you want to write an automation code for the SQL Server to take a backup. Okay, first to take a backup, you need to first connect to the SQL instance, right? So to connect to the SQL instance, if you wanted to make it go to the Java, you need to write a 10 to 15 lines of code. But when you go for Python, no need to write a 10 to 20 lines of code. You can just write one or two lines to integrate to the SQL. That level of automation is possible in Python. Like a Python, R is also one language. Like a Python, R is also one language where you are writing the programmings. Like, you know, write C, C++, Java, Python, R. All are the languages where you can make automations. So Python and R are the both competitors in data science. But my suggestion is Python. Okay. So okay, clear everyone? Yeah. When you go for Azure, so when you go for Azure, like a SQL, we have the two different things. Azure SQL developer. Okay, you can go for the developer, or you can go for Azure SQL DBA. Okay, or you can go for Azure BA, Business Intelligent. That is what someone asked, right? Okay, so what is the next I need to go for? BA, Business Intelligent. So like in traditional, we have SSIS, SSRS, right? When you go for cloud, you have ADF, ADL, ADB. Okay, Azure Data Factory, Azure Data Lake, Azure Databricks. So these are the three services is going to work as a business intelligent. So whatever activities you are doing on integration service, same thing you can do on the cloud, but your service is Azure Data Factory. Okay, Azure Data Factory. ADF is the top service for BI, business intelligent, like SSIS. So whoever, everyone knows, right, SSIS, because you are already DBAs who are already working. Okay, so SSIS, same we have in Azure as well, that is nothing but ADF, Azure Data Factory. Okay, Azure Data Factory, Azure Data Lake, Azure Data Bricks. So these are the three services belongs to the business intelligence. Got it? Everyone got it?
Yeah.
Yeah, got it.
Any doubt, any queries? Online people, everyone?
Yes, Sainath, no, actually, what is the meaning of the Azure? I mean, I know this is one of the cloud computing technology, like in terms of the AWS, we can say Azure Web Services. So what would it actually the Azure is?
That is what Azure is, a like a cloud, one of the cloud providers in the global. So we have Alibaba
That's
cloud.
True.
We have
That's true. Cloud.
Yeah.
That's true. It is a Microsoft product. It is hosted in the cloud, like the AWS and the Google cloud. So is there any like a full form of to the Azure or something?
No, this Azure, no abbreviation. So there is no standard abbreviation for Azure. I just went for the multiple micro MSDN blocks.
What is difference between Azure SQL Developer or Azure SQL DBA?
A difference between Azure SQL Developer and SQL DBA, right? So developer will write the programming language. So where they can write the queries and where they can design the stored processors, where they can write the T-SQL statements. But when you go for the DBA, you need to make sure that you need to what DBA activities, right? Installing the SQL server, configuring the SQL server, taking the backups, maintaining the services, need to be online every time. Okay, so that is the DBA activities mostly will perform. So you don't have, you no need to worry about the development. So you are not writing any code here as a DBA, but you need to know basic about what developers will perform.
Okay, understood.
Any queries?
Any?
So everyone clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay. Yeah. So this is the one important slide where everyone who are already working, okay, I'm telling, who are already working as a DBA. Okay, so I told you, right, we are going to have a different module call, okay, module 3 called advanced performance tuning. So first, when you go for advanced performance tuning, you will get one doubt where we need to start, where to start troubleshooting. Everyone in your mind, you will get multiple memory, network, new deployment code, application, configurations, TempDB, update statistics, indexes, CPU, blocking, deadlock. Where you need to start exactly, right? So everyone will have one doubt on your mind. So where we need to start, if someone is suddenly interacting with you and they are telling, so okay, my performance is something, I'm not able to connect, my performance is degrading, so my queries are taking long time to execute, okay, my complete application issues are facing timeout issue, so where you will start it? So this is the main techniques where we need to focus: network, memory, application level, new code enhancement, okay, configuration level, TempDB, update statistics, CPU, indexes, blocking, deadlocks. So these are the main key points you will get it. But where we need to start, that is the main key point everyone need to know. So that we are going to cover in this module 3, where we need to start. Okay, so clear everyone?
Yes, clear.
And yeah, okay, so we have different modules, so we have different categories when you go for the tuning level. So each parameter, each component is very important when you are working in the tuning. So what is the topmost here? So that we are going to cover completely, and I will explain you with the live demos as well. We are going to cover all this. So whatever you are getting multiple bubbles, okay? So in your brain, you will get multiple bubbles, right? So out of this, which is the topmost, where we need to first focus, that we are going to cover in the module 3. So these are the bubbles you will get it when you start the tuning your databases, tuning your application, tuning the SQL. So we are going to start from basic to advanced level. Okay, sorry. So that is what today's session I wanted to discuss today. So anything, any queries, any doubts? Okay, so before directly jump into here, so this course was completely for 60 days. Okay, every day we'll spend for 1.5 hours. Okay, 1 hour 30 minutes or 1 hour 45 minutes. Okay, and on the weekends we are going to cover 2 hour session. Okay, on weekends we are going to 2 hour session because the concept is very huge, so where I need to cover a lot. So first I'm when you go for cloud, so I'm going to explain about the cloud computing introduction. So what are the cloud computings? What are the cloud providers? What is the public cloud? What is the private cloud? What is the hybrid cloud? So what is the service model available? IaaS, PaaS, SaaS. Okay, completely we are going to discuss this part. Then we'll go for completely jump into IaaS. Under IaaS we are going to discuss about the how to deploy the VMs. Okay, so yes, so we are going to cover Azure SQL DB as well. Okay, so in IaaS we are going to discuss about the VMs, storages, networking concept completely. So network is the very, very important concept in Azure, where I am going to cover completely about 6 to 8 hour session. Okay, so where we are going to create the tunnels, where we are going to integrate on-premises to cloud. I will show you how to integrate on-premises to cloud, and also I will show you. So for example, you are using AWS, I am using Azure, how you are going to integrate AWS and Azure. That is also will show you. Okay, in Azure network, once Azure network is done, then I will go for Active Directory. So completely about Active Directories and Azure service like auto scaling, load balancing. Okay, so Azure scale set we'll cover as this part, and we'll go for PaaS. In PaaS, where we are going to complete covering about entire Azure SQL, Azure SQL database, Azure managed instance, unmanaged instance. Okay, what is the DTU? What is the Elastic Pool Stack? Okay, so how to configure SQL Elastic Pool Stack in PaaS? We are going to cover all this and complete about the on-premises to cloud migration. How you will migrate your SQL databases from on-premises to cloud. Okay, so this is the course we are going to complete covering over the Azure session. So when you go for SQL DBA, so from scratch onwards we are going to cover starting with the SQL Server 2014, 2016, 2017, along with 2019. Okay, so we are going to 2019 as well. So installation and configurations I'm going to cover complete. Okay, and I'm going to cover the databases. So what is the data file, what is the log file, file groups, everything, and also completing about the security part. So complete about the security end-to-end permissions level. As a DBA, you need to must should know about how you will grant the permissions, means how you will protect your data. As a DBA, we need to know about the backups and restores. Okay, how you are going to take the backups and the restores, that is also we are going to cover. And the automation, like creating the jobs, creating the maintenance plans, using the whole Halogen scripts, using the PowerShell, using the native SQL maintenance plans, we are going to cover all this automation part. Okay, and when you go for high availability technique, replication, okay, and always on log shipping, okay, end-to-end case studies materials, okay, mirroring, database mirroring, and clustering and always on. Once it is done, then we will go for the advanced performance tuning level. So this is the concept we are going to cover in advanced performance tuning level. Troubleshooting like common issues. So first we'll discuss the common issues, then we'll go for the CPU related issues, SQL OS, schedulers, preemptive scheduler, corporate scheduler, what is the quantum, scheduling the threads, schedulers, okay, scheduling algorithm, and thread lifecycle. This is going to cover over the SQL CPU issues. When you go for memory, buffer pool uses, okay, reservation clocks, PLE, memory grants per pending. This is we are going to cover in the memory part. On IO part, we are going to use IO stalls, disk latency, SQL IO latency. Okay, apart from this, we'll discuss the wait types, performance counters, everything. So apart from this, so always on troubleshooting, real-time troubleshooting, mirroring troubleshooting, replication troubleshooting, log shipping, and mirroring troubleshooting as well. Okay, so so this is the course content which we are going to cover throughout these 60 days.